Well, thank you so much. I want to thank you all for joining us today for the Private Practice Millionaire Academy. And I am so excited to take a few minutes to introduce our incredible presenter, the financial prosperity coach, P. Christopher Music. Now, Christopher is a 20-plus year veteran of the financial planning profession. He is a best-selling author and a personal financial planning expert. Now, a lot of you have seen him on ABC, Fox, CBS, affiliates all over the country. He's also been featured in Forbes magazine, Newsweek, The Wall Street Journal, and of course, various healthcare industry publications. And he has also penned a chapter for two best-selling books, More Better, and also his most recent bestseller with Steve Forbes of Forbes magazine, of course, which is titled Successonomics. Some of his other published materials include the Financial Success Guides and the Private Practice Millionaire Audio Program with the best-selling author from the E-Myth, Michael Gerber. Christopher is the founder of Econologics Institute, and he developed the Private Practice Millionaire Academy for private practice professionals who intend to achieve financial prosperity and financial power. He has successfully delivered financial planning workshops to hundreds of private practice owners and their spouses, and has helped those people improve their overall financial condition and experience so they can continue to live their art. Please stand and help me welcome the incredible Christopher Music.
Thank you. Thank you. Good morning. Good morning. So, welcome to the Private Practice Millionaire Academy. Now, this next 3 days, I bet you couldn't imagine that when you signed up to attend this course, you said, 3 days? Talk about finances? Oh my gosh, what are we going to talk about? Well, the Private Practice Millionaire Academy was designed just for you. And it is simply a codification of 25 years of material that I've developed to help you have the most positive financial experience you can have while you live your art, whatever it is for you. So I want to cover with you, really, what the title of this academy is. The Private Practice Millionaire Academy, the ultimate financial training for a professional practice owner's business and household wealth. So it's a very comprehensive amount of information. Now, let's define what these terms are in the title, so we make sure we're in the right spot. Now, first of all, the Private Practice Millionaire Academy starts with private practice. Now, what is private practice? It is the practice of one's profession as an independent rather than as an employee. Now, one of the things you're going to find in the world of financial advice, I'm going to talk a lot about that during this next 3 days, because the airwaves are filled, the print is filled, the media, the video world is filled with droning on of financial advice and information. The problem is we have to ask ourselves to be able to evaluate it. Does it apply to us? And you're going to find that the vast majority of the things you hear do not apply to you. I find that pretty interesting. So what we're going to talk about is information that is directly applicable to your experience as a private practice professional, one who is an independent rather than as an employee. So you can see there's two different universes there, two different applications of information in the way that you go through your life. So that's private practice. Now we have millionaire. Millionaire is a person whose wealth amounts to a million or more. Now you can kind of see where that's maybe a bit of a dated definition because of the devaluation of money, but I don't care how many millions there are, as long as there's millions. Does that make sense to you? Okay, now, sometimes we mention, well, I want to be a millionaire. And we get this twinge, like, I don't know if I should really want that or not. Well, understand something. How much money you make is an indicator of the value you provide. You follow that? Because money's only value, it's only exists, the reason it exists at all is because it represents value. It's a unitary measurement of value. And when you go out there and provide value in the world, people will give you something valuable in return. Now, you may not need what they do for a living. Let's say that they're an auto mechanic, and you already have an auto mechanic. So when you deliver your veterinary services, for example, to an auto mechanic, you may not need his services in return. So he will give you something that represents the value of that, which is a monetary unit called a dollar. Do you see how that works? So a million of those is how many? A lot, right? So all we want to make sure that we do is be able to experience the benefits and the fruits of providing value. So it's totally okay to be a millionaire. Do you agree? Raise your hand if you agree. Good. Now, how many millions? That is entirely up to you. Some people say, I can't possibly think about living being worth less than $10 million. Great. Then they will go out and provide enough value to accumulate $10 million. Others will say, you know what? A million or two is fine with me. Great. Then that can be yours too. So you need to decide for yourself. And through these 3 days, you will decide for yourself how many millions you want for you. And of course, a millionaire is any very rich person. Now, rich is also a relative term, isn't it? Because you see, real wealth isn't money. What is real wealth? It's production. And more importantly, it's your ability. Who's the wealthier person? A person who has built a business successfully and lost it, and all I have to do is just rebuild it again, or a person who never had that experience trying to start a business? Who's the richer person? The one with the experience and the ability, right? Of course. So if nothing else, don't get caught up in the money side of it. That's just an indicator. What really is valuable is your ability to create. Do you see? And finally, an academy. The academy is a school or college for special instruction or training in a subject. That's why I called it an academy. Because you see, throughout your entire existence as a professional, I would presume pretty safely that you have never gotten an education in economics and finance. Would that be true? Okay. Now, you went to elementary school, middle school, high school. You went to college, professional school. You probably got some continuing education from your profession. You've gotten all of this technical training. But how much business training did you get? I'll let you in on a secret. I have a master's degree in business administration. Do you know what that means? Absolutely nothing. Because college teaches people how to be employees of publicly traded companies. That's what it teaches. And all the theory that's put in textbooks to teach marketing and finance and economics is all about, hey, you work for IBM or General Electric. How are you going to position your company's products on the world market? And that's all it's about, and it's all theory. And it does have nothing to do with, gee, I want to start my own business. So I had to learn that from scratch. Now, I had trained in that. You are a professional in what you do. Now, the Private Practice Millionaire Academy is for private practice professionals. What professionals? Well, healthcare professionals, people like dentists, doctors, veterinarians, optometrists, ophthalmologists, podiatrists, and on and on and on. So all the specialties. But also applies to people who are in the financial field or even the sales field, like real estate agents, insurance agents, financial advisors, accountants, mortgage brokers, anybody who has a professional license who is out there trying to be an entrepreneur and start their own business. That's what this training is all about over these 3 days. So what I've endeavored to do throughout this particular three-day summary is give you the Cliff's Notes version of an entire deleted financial education. Is that okay with you that we do that? Okay, good. So I'm going to be repeating concepts. If I repeat the concept, guess what? That's very important to remember and use. If it's not on this course, guess what? It's not important. Now, that's a broad statement, and of course, I could come under criticism for saying that, but We're covering basic fundamentals. We can get into complications beyond complications. That's not the interest of this particular course. This is brought out to a level where you can use the information and use basic fundamental principles that have always been true. And this is a basic training. Now, this course is also designed for you to review and take again and again and again. Because after 3 days, are you going to remember everything? There's no way. You're going to walk out of here at the end of the third day saying, I'm dizzy. I feel like I just drank from a fire hose. And you will. And in probably 1 year, you'll probably retain maybe 7% of what you learned. So this is designed to, this is why it's being recorded. So we can review the material again and again, because these are always going to be true fundamentals, no matter what time and place they're applied. Now, what I want to do now is, before we get into this next slide, I want you to pull out this Route to Financial Power, this blue page. This gives us an overall concept of the subject. Now, the Route to Financial Prosperity for the Private Practice Millionaire starts with the all the online material that we have. Funny, hear all the clicks. Okay, articles and newsletters, books, special reports, lectures, online media. Now, these are materials that we created through the Conlogix Institute to educate all of you through all the different media, audio, video, text, whatever the case may be. Then we have the Financial Prosperity Index Questionnaire, which is our 100-question questionnaire that gives us the result, a graphical result, of the financial condition of your household. And then we have what's called the Practice Transition Readiness Assessment, which then gives us an assessment, a graphical representation, of your readiness to transition out of your professional practice to someone else for maximum value, which is a very different product than many things that you might be used to. Then as we evaluate those, then we kind of move into this particular 3-day academy. Now, this 3-day academy, there's abilities that I want you to gain from attending this course. First of all, it's knowledge and application of, there's 26 points of what I call the code of a household CFO, Chief Financial Officer, and you're gonna learn about that. And there's a code, there's a code of behavior. It's a training material for you to be able to competently be able to manage your household and practice finances to a level of prosperity, financial power. So that is what this course is about. And along with that comes the implementation side, which you'll find on the right side. It's all great and fine to learn about concepts and material and knowledge and so on and so forth. It's quite another to apply it to get results. And again, only thing we're interested in as professionals is technical results. So on the implementation side, we have our financial plan, our transition plan to get the job done. So everything you'll learn on this 3-day course is going to be applied one-on-one with an advisor who can take you through step-by-step through our programs to achieve the results intended from this particular course. Then one of the things that we want to make sure we do is, just because we know something and begin to apply it, a plan is something that's done over a lifetime. And so it takes a very important level of attention on at least an annual basis to review the plan and to update it and to keep it useful as we live our lives. And then as we get these fundamentals in, these are basics. This is a basic procedure. Then we get into advanced strategies. Now, the world of financial planning is very diverse. You're going to find that every subject we talk about in this course can be taken to an incredible level of complexity and technical application. You can get a PhD in just about everything. Well, I'm quite sure you're not interested in how the car works. All you would be interested in is, does the car turn on? Can I put it in gear? Can I step on the gas and steer it without hitting a tree? And that's the level I'm giving you. But you're going to find that as we go through this course, this subject that we're covering is a new subject. And it is, in my view, the next evolution of what financial advisors will do with their clients universally, because it's based on a system that gets results, which has not occurred before. So I want to make sure that we understand that just because we're getting involved here today, there's a lot more to do. For example, how would you be interested, perhaps, in a course on how to save taxes that applies to you as private practice owners that's in simple fourth grade English? Would you like that? Of course, right? Because how many of you would like to dig into 60,000 pages of the tax code and try to figure out what to do? No, we ask our accountants, right? And do they always talk in language that can be understood? No. Okay, so I understand why there's lack of application. So the whole purpose of what I'm doing is basically bringing down all the complication into simple actions, because I would imagine that if you had a passion about financial planning, you would have become financial planners. But you didn't, because you have passions in other areas, right? Veterinarians, dentistry, optometry, podiatry, whatever the case may be. Of course, right? So all I'm trying to do is help you along the way so that it's not so complicated and it's not, you know, kind of putting you into a position where you're going to hit bridge abutments and trees and pedestrians along the way on your route. I want to make sure that you arrive safely to where you want to go. So that is the whole purpose of what we're doing in this particular academy.